Hey everybody, it's Alex, the founder and CEO at Motoroso, and in this video, we're gonna be covering all the new aftermarket front and rear bumper options for the brand new Ford Bronco. And there are a lot of options to talk about because we just got back from SEMA 2021. There were over 50 amazing Bronco builds out there, and there's products from over 20 different manufacturers that we're gonna talk about in this video. And that means we're not gonna be able to dive into extremely deep detail about every single product the way we normally do, but we will put links in the description to the products on our website where you can learn more and of course, shop for those products. You can always reach out to us with more questions on live chat or on our toll-free number. Make sure to subscribe to the channel because we're getting our Bronco in about 2 weeks, and we have a big build plan. We'll be doing review videos and detailed how-to installation guides. You're gonna wanna follow along. Now, when you're shopping for bumpers, there's a lot to consider because there's a lot of different features and options for how you configure these things. First of all, do you wanna run a winch or no winch? Would you like a pre-runner bar, a big stinger bar, or no bar at all? Do you want D-ring mounts? Are you planning on running LED lighting? Is it gonna retain the OEM skid plate, or do they offer an aftermarket skid plate to complement the bumper? How wide do you want it? Do you want the mid-width, a fender width, or do you want it to go beyond and line up with the wide fenders? Now, does it flow enough air through to the intercooler, which is really important on these new turbo applications for the Bronco? In the rear, will it clear the tow hitch receiver? Or will it work with the spare tire carrier you've chosen to run that'll carry a big enough tire that you're on? And will it work with the electronics package you've chosen? That means things like the parking sensors, adaptive cruise control, and that new Bronco 360 camera system. Now we're gonna try and list off as many of these features for every one of these bumpers as we can, but in many cases, these were actually early prototypes of these products and the final details of the product may even still be getting worked out. Now by the time you watch this video, whether it's a month or a year after this video has come out, there's definitely going to be more information. So again, check out the links in the description or hit us up on live chat or toll free. Let's dig in. Now before we talk about full bumper replacement, some of you out there might just want to protect the stock bumper or add some functionality. So for that, Aries makes their forefront bull bar, which is $379 and an easy installation. Rough Country is making their nudge bar for only $279 and includes a spot to mount some LED lights. And Rough Country is also making a winch mount for only $309. These are inexpensive ways to protect that front bumper and add a little bit of functionality. But now let's talk about full bumper replacements. Let's start off first with the offering from our friends over at Addictive Desert Designs, who always bring it to the table with the design. Now, as usual, very angular, very low profile, super aggressive look. It's got lots of openings at the front that can fit up to 3 6-inch round LED lights and still allow air to flow around and into that intercooler, as well as 2 2-inch corner LED lights. Now this is a low profile design. It's gonna give you a high angle of attack and it can either work with the OEM skid plate with some modification or you can get their aftermarket skid plate. Pricing is not official on this yet, but expect it to be somewhere in that $2,000 to $2,300 price point. Now they're also gonna be introducing a version of this bomber that is winch compatible. That's gonna make it a little bit larger, and while the regular bomber has no obstruction of any of the cameras or sensors, they said that the new bomber with the winch might have a little bit of obstruction, but everything should still work okay. Expect that to bump up the price just a touch. Now they also introduced a Rock Fighter, which has a low profile pre-runner bar and is winch compatible, and it'll accommodate a 20-inch LED light bar. This one's gonna set you back around $2,400. And they didn't have this at SEMA, but they are gonna be making their very famous Stealth Fighter bumper. Very, very low profile, will handle a 30-inch light bar, 2 3x3 light pods in each corner for a total of 4 LED lights. And that's gonna set you back around $2,100. And if you want the Stealth Fighter skid plate, that's another $750. But this one is non-winch compatible, but super low profile. ADD is gonna be offering a bomber rear bumper and a Rock Fighter rear bumper. Of course, both the designs are gonna match the front bumpers as well. And they're gonna work with tow hitches and all the parking sensors and have D-ring mounts, everything you expect from a top of the line product. Now our friends over at Fab Four sadly didn't have a Bronco at their booth, but of course they've designed product for it and we love it. The Vengeance front bumper is gonna be one of their new offerings that is a non-winch compatible bumper, very high and tight, low profile design, very aggressive angular design as well. Now this is available with and without a pre-runner bar, depending on how you like it. And this bumper is gonna start at around $1,500. It'll accommodate a 20-inch single row LED light bar and 2 3x3 pods in each corner for a total of 4. They'll also be offering the matching Vengeance rear bumper starting at $1,100 that can accommodate 1 3x3-inch light pod on each corner. Fab Fours will also be introducing the Matrix front bumper, which is going to be their winch-compatible bumper. Still a very aggressive, low-profile design, but it's also going to accommodate that 20-inch single-row LED and two 3x3 light pods on each corner, and it's going to have a skid plate option available as well. No pricing on this just yet. And to match that Matrix front bumper, you'd want to look for their premium rear bumper. Now, as usual with Fab Fours, expect them to come out with a grumper eventually. They're super aggressive, wild-looking designs that we cannot wait to see what that looks like on a Bronco. By the way, they're also probably going to come up with a bunch of other products like fenders and their 40s with no lift design. Keep a solid eye on Fab Fours and all the products that they're planning to come out with. Moving on to the folks over at DV8, they've introduced this big, beefy winch mount bumper with this massive reinforced Stinger pre-runner guard. Now that thing might interfere with some of your sensors, so we're gonna need to figure out a little bit more about that. Now this thing can accommodate a 20-inch dual-row LED, and it has this cool skid plate with vents and die-cut logo. No pricing available on this one yet. One thing that makes this one very unique is that it is actually two bumpers in one because it has these add-on wings. It's a mid-width bumper that has add-on wings that makes it a full-width bumper. We didn't see anything else like that at SEMA this year. DV8 also making the matching rear bumper that is much lower profile than the front. Now this has got spots to mount LED reverse lights, and it's very, very low profile to accommodate their spare tire relocation. Now their spare tire carrier is a beefy boy. It'll handle a 37-inch tire, it looks great with all that tubing, and it reinforces that door and relocates that third brake light. Weston Automotive introduced their HDX Gen 2 bumper, which is a big, beefy, winch-compatible bumper with a massive reinforced Stinger bar that's bound to interfere with some of the sensors and cameras. Now, this thing can accommodate two 6-inch LED lights and two 2x2 pods, and it's got a skid plate integrated. It's basically got everything you would want in a bumper, and it's probably going to come in at a pretty good price because Weston is usually a lot of value for the money. They also introduced their ProMod bumper, which is their modular design. It helps it be a little bit lower profile. This is a non-winch compatible bumper, but a nice aggressive look. Again, no pricing on this just yet. As far as rear bumpers go from Weston, you're gonna find the matching HDX Gen 2 bumper, which is gonna have a bunch of features built into it, including four mounting bolts on each corner that we couldn't quite figure out what that was for. We think they're gonna be introducing some future accessories, maybe a spare tire mount with the hinge on it or a roof ladder, something like that. And again, the design is going to match that HDX Gen 2 front. In the rear, if you've got the ProMod Series bumper, you might look at the Pro Series rear bumper, a much cleaner, angular design, and a lighter, lower profile design in general. Road Armor introduced their Stealth bumper, which is obviously not in reference to their branding. What it means is that they've integrated the winch into the bumper and it's not as visible. And that also means that it doesn't live above that bumper line and it doesn't interfere with any of the cameras or sensors. Now this also has a spot to mount LED lights, and this thing's gonna set you back around $2,000. They've also got the matching rear bumper with D-ring mounts, spots for LED lights, and of course, their logo. Now the most popular bumper that we saw in the entire show on more builds than any other was the new Warn Elite front bumper. For very good reason, it's a very simple, clean design. It's got all the features you could want. It can accommodate a winch. It has spots for 3-inch round LED lights. And it's available with and without a pre-runner bar. Now this thing costs $1,700 without the pre-runner bar and $1,800 with it. And for a product that's made in the United States, that is a great value. Now this bumper does stick out past the fender line. So if you're gonna do fender deletes, keep in mind, that's gonna stick out a little bit. Might look a little weird, but if you're gonna keep fender flares, it's gonna look fantastic. Warn's rear bumper does not feature any mounting locations for D-rings or LED lights, but it is a nice, simple, clean design to match the front. Unfortunately, no pricing on the rear bumper yet. Heading on over to the ARB booth, there were now two offerings for the Bronco, and we'll start with their traditional Summit front bumper. This thing is a beast. This is the biggest front bumper we saw at SEMA, and it is a monster. It has a full integrated bull bar and grill guard that covers the lights. It allows you to mount LED lights, it handles a winch, and it's gonna cost you about $1,700. I have no idea what this thing weighs, but you're gonna need heavier springs to support this front bumper for sure. ARB also introduced their new Zenith front bumper for the Bronco, and this is one of my favorite products that I saw for the Bronco. This thing is gorgeous. It's got the really low profile, angular, aggressive, and modern design to it, and a couple of features that makes it look very different from anything else that we saw at the show, including those powder-coated red tow hooks and that stainless steel skid plate that wraps around the front of the bumper. Now, it'll also accommodate a single row 20-inch LED light bar, and it's not winch compatible, but it's got a nice big opening to let air flow into that intercooler to make sure you don't overheat this boosted engine. I think this product was beautiful, and it comes in at $16.95, the same price as that Giant Summit from Bumper. But in my opinion, one of the top picks from SEMA this year. And they are making a matching Zenith rear bumper. I don't know if it's called the Zenith, but the design is very angular and aggressive and looks exactly the same. Unfortunately, no pricing on that rear bumper. Now, before we move on from ARB to another brand, I want to mention that they were the only company that brought out a full skid plate system for the Bronco, and it set you back about $700. And I think this is a must have if you're going to do any wheeling. You got to protect the underbody of this vehicle. Now, if you like a really aggressive, minimalist, low-profile, tubular-style, Baja-style look, SVC Off-Road has a winch-compatible and non-winch-compatible version of their Baja-style bumper. This is extremely low-profile and minimalist, though. It doesn't even appear to support the parking sensors. It'll set you back around $1,500 without a winch and $1,900 with a winch. We didn't see a matching rear bumper. It looks like Iron Cross is also rolling out one of their heavy-duty, beefy bumpers, as you expect from that brand. And it does not appear that it was finished, because it didn't seem to have everything mounted up to it. But it does look like a pretty nice design. It's got that medium-sized stinger. No pricing on this one either yet. Havoc Off-Road has introduced their Metal Masher front bumper. Now, this is a tubular, Baja-style, very low-profile, high-ground clearance bumper, but it's got these vented inserts to create, like, panels look. Very nice-looking on the Bronco. Now, this is non-winch compatible, but it will support a 20-inch light bar. No pricing available for this one just yet. One thing that was definitely unique about this Metal Masher is that they offer D-ring mount locations with three different positions, depending on how you want that D-ring to hang. Havoc also introduced their Steel Bender bumper, which is a more traditional style, boxed off looking bumper, and it has a pre-runner bar, but it's a pretty low profile pre-runner bar, so it doesn't interfere too much with the cameras and the sensors. Now, this has that same three position D-ring mounting location, which looks pretty cool, and it also features a spot for a 20-inch LED light bar. And they're making a matching rear Steel Bender bumper as well, and of course the design is very, very similar. It's got D-ring mount locations and a spot for some reverse lights. Havoc Off-Road is also one of the companies offering a spare tire relocation plate that'll accommodate up to a 37-inch tire and relocates the third brake light. Better known for their suspension products, Icon Vehicle Dynamics has introduced front and rear bumpers for the new Bronco. Now, this is definitely a unique looking bumper, and I don't know what to say about it other than it looks different from everything else that is out there. They did tell us that this is probably not the final design, so there may be a lot of changes, but currently it'll house a winch, it has spots for 3-inch cube lights on the front bumper, and on the rear bumper it has cutouts for their proprietary shaped rear reverse lights. So check this one out in the future. Could be a lot of developments here from Icon. They make amazing suspensions, so I would not be surprised if these bumpers turn out to be pretty legit. Another great product came from AFN. Now, this is a very unique looking bumper with its riveted style trim plates around the LED light mounting points, and it does have a hidden winch mount. This thing is heavy duty. You can tell the skid plate looked like it's almost a third of an inch steel on there, and I'm expecting them to come out with a matching rear bumper. Crawltech has introduced a new front bumper that is very, very low profile, but still integrates a winch. The winch mounts below the bumper, very, very low down, without sacrificing too much ground clearance. Now, this thing is so low profile, it's going to have absolutely no interference whatsoever with any of the cameras, sensors, or the adaptive cruise control. Now, they also produced a matching rear bumper that also has a winch mount. This was the only Bronco that we saw that had front and rear winches. We think that's really awesome. And this maintains still that very, very low profile design, so it's not going to mess with any of the sensors, and it's going to give you great angle of attack out on the trail. We don't have any pricing available for these products yet, but we're going to be keeping a real close eye on this. Expedition One has also introduced a set of front and rear bumpers with a nice, clean, angular design. It's a top winch mount. It has a couple spots for LED lights, everything you'd expect there. What we liked about this product was that they actually created a spare tire carrier that hinges off of the bumper, and that'll support up to a 37-inch tire and take that weight off of the tailgate. Nice looking product. No pricing available for that one just yet either. If you're looking for a really unique design, check out this bumper from Hawk. Now, this thing reminds me of an armored vehicle. Feels very much like it belongs in the military. It's also got all the features you're looking for, though. It's got a winch mount, places for LED lights and D-ring mounts, and the rear bumper, of course, to match. Now, they built in a spare tire carrier that can support up to a 40-inch tire, and it's got a big box metal construction. Very unique look from Hawk. Another very unique product coming from Bodyguard. Now, they've got this really angular, aggressive look with vents and these exposed silver studs that make the whole thing look different from just about anything else that we saw. Now, it also accommodates a winch, LED lights, and D-rings, anything that you would expect. The LED light is actually integrated into the pre-runner bar if you opt for that. And that bumper will cost you $2,300, and you can get the matching rear bumper for around $1,400. Now, both of these take into consideration lining up with the outside of the body line so you can go with Bodyguard's fender delete and everything will look nice and clean. Bodyguard is also the only company that we saw that actually introduced a spare tire mount delete kit, so you can actually get rid of the spare tire mount altogether. Several builds also featured a new product from Baja Forged, and like the name suggests, it's going to be a very Baja-style looking bumper, but somehow they just pull off making these things look really crisp and clean. The lines that they follow and their nice little steel plates that they insert in the bumper give it a much more refined look than some of the other just very minimalistic Baja-style bumpers that you might find. It also includes an integrated winch mount, a beautiful skid plate. We have no idea what the pricing is going to be on this yet, but we think this is probably the best looking Baja-style bumper out there, and there's a rear to match. Von Gittin's Funhaver brand also introduced their off-road bumper, which is a non-winch bumper, but features a nice reinforced stinger bar that looks a little different from other applications, which you might expect from this brand. No pricing on this just yet, and it's not on their website, but this is another one to check out. Another common option on a lot of the builds, just because they came to market very, very quickly, was the 4WP Factory. Now, this has a really cool tubular and sheet style design. It's a little bit Baja and a little bit traditional bumper. Has an optional winch mount that can support a 12K winch and an optional skid plate. With all the options, this thing's gonna set you back upwards of about $2,000, and it's got spots to mount LED lights on the front and, of course, a matching rear bumper. 4WP Factory also offers a matching spare tire relocation kit that moves the spare tire up and out of the way and can accommodate a 35, and it's only $200. No matter which bumpers you choose, you're gonna need to install them on the vehicle, and we're gonna show you how to do that on our own Bronco build, which we're getting in 2 weeks. So remember, subscribe to the channel to see those how-to videos. Now, if you wanna improve the suspension on your vehicle, make sure you check out our Bronco suspension video right over here. We're gonna go through all the available lift kits and all the suspension upgrades for that Bronco. And if you have questions about the bumpers that we talked about in this video, check out the description for all the links that we can provide, as well as you can reach us on live chat or call us toll-free at 833-MOTOROSO. Thanks for watching.